Hey guys, Kirkhee here. Welcome to the Metroid Dread speedrun tutorial, where today we'll be continuing the No Major Glitches run. The whole setup for this is, today we'll be going, we, in the last part, just finished off by grabbing the super missiles, which is why we are where we are, as our little morph ball Chozo Samus. We're gonna go from here. The next thing we'll be grabbing is the plasma beam. And from there, we're going to continue on straight through to the gravity suit. There's a lot to cover, and oh, some of these spots are going to get tricky. So let's jump right into this. So after you grab this right here, ideally, that door will still be open. So you want to try to flash step out through there in time. If you can't, that's fine. Most of the time, I actually can't. So you'll want to grab onto that wall right here with this. And then come up here, bomb this out, use your super missiles to bust that out, wait for this to slowly open, flash step across there, go up here. As you come up this ledge, you'll typically be holding left, you won't be stopping like I will. So give a little hop so you can, well, that didn't work because when I came out of that and turned, I hit up on the analog some. So ideally you want to come out of here, go up like that just to get through there a little quicker, save a few frames, bust that open, hold a charge in for here and shoot up. Doing that will allow you to get this area opened up a little quicker. There is a thing you can do here to save a bit of time, but I find it to be really difficult, and if you miss it, you're actually losing time, so it's not worth it. So you go like this, and you go into the morph ball. As you're going up, you release the grapple, go into the morph ball, and land here. Like I said, it's quite tricky to do. It's not worth doing for the few frames it'll save. So just this one here, once you grab here, just flop over like that as you normally would. This one you can jump up into like that. Just know, for whatever reason, when you're coming out of here, it's hard to just turn straight around and go up into that. So you might have to get a little distance back. Drop a bomb in here, and this will take us on to the next spot, where I will once again have to stop and explain how the next section works, because it kind of happens really fast. So here, obviously, we gotta use the super missile and then bust the door open. Once we go through this door, we will have to jump, and at the peak of our jump, flash step to the right. Doing this will put us between the giant whale-like creature. I typically call it a sperm whale, you know, haha, funny sperm. You typically jump between the whale and the ledge, and, well, I'll show you. So you do a big jump, you typically continue to flash step there, but I didn't think I was actually going to make it, so I didn't continuously flash step. So you normally land here and just continue flash stepping. You'd land down in here somewhere where you can just jump up, grab this, and flash step your way through. Once again, if you want to get a little more space between your flash steps, you want to put a little jump in there before flash stepping. It'll give you an extra 6 blocks total distance, so it'll almost give you an extra distance worth of a full flash step. So we'll head into Elune next. I used to make a coming inside of Ellen joke here, but I'm sure the wrong or right person heard that. They'd probably be offended by it, and it's like, you know, it's not worth the joke. Even though I put it out there, I don't care. It's just a joke. It's not serious. In any case, two things you can do here. You can either speed boost your way through here like so. I actually can't go back now. Or you can flash step, and it pretty much leads to the same thing. You skip this completely. Do 3 flash steps here. Where this guy's crumbling, you want to drop a bomb off. Drop a bomb here, jump. Drop a bomb here, jump. Go over here, drop a bomb, and it'll take you through this lovely pipe. Boom, 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 boom. That'll get us up through there. We'll quickly zip up through this way, which is a nice little spot. Here, you don't need to go off this back wall. I typically do it because that jump there is a little tight and can easily be missed. So we'll come through here, skip this scene. You can skip that scene just as it's loading up. So drop a bomb, flash step through. If you do this spot right, as you're flash stepping through, you can grab that ledge and do a little... It'll do with a little hop up. I actually can't do it from standing here because we'll try to do it like this to show you, provided I can get back up through here. So you drop like this, flash step, And when you grab that ledge, you can give a little hop up. I missed the hop again, but that's fine. Flash step through there. You can hop over that guy, which I'm surprised I got. Flash step there. Jump up, hit that. Hop over that. That's the first time I've ever skipped both of them. I've never gotten that before now, so I'm kind of happy that happened. Once you get out of here, you can immediately shoot a missile, which... just want to touch on this. Does it make anyone else confused why this door is actively a red door, noting that it's just normal missiles that's needed? It makes no sense, because you actively have to use super missiles to get to this point, as far as I know. So why didn't they make this a super missile door? That would suggest there's a way to get in here without super missiles. In any case, once you bust this area open, you'll want to hit it in a 2-1 pattern. You'll want just a 1-block gap there. And we'll grab this. The reason you want that 1-block gap is because we're going to set up another Shine Spark out through here, or Speed Booster. We're not going to actually use the Shine Spark itself. And normally, this piece wouldn't have time to spawn in, because once you get up through here, you hit that, you grab it. It'll spawn in once you get about here. So, the way this would work is you go there, you shoot. As you set that off, I jumped a little early. I can't do this whole sequence, by the way. There's a lot to this, and as far as I can get it on a good run is to the door in the next room that we've already been through. So, go something like this. So, you jump here, and I screwed it up. So normally you get a high enough jump that you go up through here. I'll try it a couple times to show you. I'll actually go ahead and show you the easy method, or the beginner method first. It's more just jump up through here. Enemies are not setting in the right spots anymore. Shoot through here and continue on. I'm gonna have to I can't actually attack these enemies. I forgot about that, because they spark. So with the Shine Spark, we'll go like this. I missed it again. It's a tricky jump. It's a lot of really fast inputs. If you don't get this, it's not worth coming back to do. Trust me, you'll lose time. So this is, well, I did my last couple jumps a little too quick, but you can get here. If you get here and land your feet, you can shoot this open, which will let you, I'm actually going to do this so I can get a little health back, just in case. But if you get here, get that door shot open fast enough, you can continue to carry that momentum through here. You would go into a morph ball and go across here, or to be more precise, you would shoot that open and then go into a morph ball to go across there with your speed boost, so you wouldn't lose it. Because if you, with the speed boost, in a situation like that, when you land, it'll make you lose your speed, and I'm not sure why. It's like a normal jump. You've seen it in the last part. A normal jump like that while speed boosting does not make you lose your jump. But a spot like this will. I don't think I can get enough speed here to show you as an example. No, unfortunately, there's not enough room there to show you as an example. But you pretty much have to morph ball off there just to be on the safe side so you wouldn't lose it. In any case, flash step through here. And if you do it right, which for some reason that didn't work for me this time, you will avoid this guy narrowly. And the way you would want to do this normally, I'm actually going to let this kill me off so I can show you all this in one fluid motion. So, the way you would do that afterwards, if I mess up the speed boost here, that's perfectly fine. I'll continue on showing you the rest of it. Yeah, that's fine. So even that saves a little bit of time over not doing it all. So you flash step over him, flash step through there, grapple there, flash step across here, flash step here, wait. I did not wait that out. That's why he hit me. So, oh, that's actually one thing I'm going to point out here. If you flash step into an enemy, you actually don't take damage immediately, because your flash step will fall short. Samus has like a air brakes in there that'll just immediately stop you up before you hit the enemy like that. So that can be useful at times. So, from here, we're going to have to skip a cutscene, drop a missile, and just start mashing. Oh, I hate where my arm is not warmed up to this at all. Now, here's one of the few spots I do a double thumb mash like this. But unfortunately, I won't be able to do it this time because I actually took damage in the first phase. If you don't take damage in the first phase, you use the double thumb mashing, you can damage boost your way through the second phase and save a little time. Unfortunately, like I said, I took damage, so I won't be able to do that. Alternatively, if you have a turbo controller or are really good at button mashing, you can do what I'm doing now and try to shoot some missiles in with regular shots. I can sort of semi-do it, but if you use a turbo controller, which this is why I feel turbo has the unfair advantage, in between every one of these shots, they can guarantee a missile without slowing down the regular shot. Which, like I said, unfair advantage. They have, and it all comes down to how fast they have the cap for the turbo. They have it at 20 hertz. Next to no one can shoot at 20 hertz. In any case, we go this way. If you want one more energy tank, there's one here. But most people cap out between, well, the average of casual gamers is around 3 button presses a second, so 3 hertz. For speedrunners, it hits somewhere around 11 to 13 hertz. I fall right in the middle. Single thumb, I can hit between 11 and 12. Double thumbs, I can hit almost 15 at times. They have like that almost double advantage over some people, and it's a huge unfair advantage in that regard. So you noticed when I came out of this spot up here, you may not have picked up on it since it is subtle. I did a little jump so it would keep me in the morph ball. That's just so I fall down faster. So we'll be skipping here. We'll go into a speed. I didn't need to do the turnaround. I didn't mean to do the turnaround. So we open this door, and aim when you hit the platform to stop yourself dead in your tracks. That's actually an important thing going forward. As you're running, actually, even early on, if you're running and you want to stop on a dime, you just aim. It will stop you up on the spot. Samus has, like, super hydraulics in her suit or something. So when she's running like that, she aims, her whole system locks up. It's gotta be really traumatic on her body. And then you skip this cutscene here. 222 runs in, and I still always forget that stupid cutscene. Every damn time. I've literally only remembered and skipped that cutscene maybe twice. So now that we're back here, double flash step, which will put us here, which actually put us a little too far ahead. So it normally puts you about here. So we want to, thank you, door, because I stopped and explained stuff. So yeah, it normally puts you about here, which you'll see, actually, the grapple can reach really far if the screen allows it. So pull that back, do a little bit of a run here, jump, shoot. So I shot there before I landed, and doing that, it killed my speed. So I will, if I can get, thank you, actually, not sarcastic thank you either. It actually helped me across there. So I will try this again. I can't do this whole sequence either, but if you do this whole sequence right, you can go right on to where the Emmy is with speed boost. But I'm not there yet. I haven't actually sat down and practiced this yet. I've only done what you're about to see now during runs. So after you get the land there and get the shots off, you should... Would you kindly go away? I am talking. My God, what are you made out of? I'm going to eat these guys while I'm here. So, yeah, like I was saying, you'd normally jump and then go into a morph ball. But before that, you have to shoot that door open without aiming like this, obviously, because this will stop up your speed running. So as you're running through, you shoot like that. You jump and go into a morph ball, which will put you on this platform. This door will be open, so you'll go through. From here, you come back to your feet, come out of the morph ball, jump up through here. The furthest I've ever gotten has been this spot right here. So you jump up through here with all this, which will put you through him, lets you continue on through here and into this spot. So you can also start one from right here and try to do this. But this is also very risky to do, because it triggers the Emmy to come after you. That's why I'm not stopping and explaining what I'm doing here. In fact, now that I've stopped and say, or I've made it in this room, I can actually load the last checkpoint and explain this out a little bit. I'll actually just go in normal as well, so I can more easily explain it. So coming in here, you'll want to slide through here, flash step. Flash step will alert the enemy, so you'll want to bust those out. Grapple up here really quick. Go through this door as fast as you can. Grapple up. Flash shift left. Grapple up here. Ah, shoot. I missed my jump. Oh, this is bad. I'm actually... Okay, we recovered it. You know what? You're being a real jerk, Emmy. Come here. Come here. I want to stop you up. Well, stop it. I'm going to go back out so we can do this over again because the stupid thing keeps getting in my road. It's almost like it doesn't realize I'm trying to show you guys how to do this stuff. And it's just being a big old jerk about it. I should have just loaded the checkpoint. It would have been faster. All right, let's try this again. This time we'll take the more dangerous routing for this, which I failed miserably. Yeah, now you're going to see why you don't do it like this. As you can see, the risk reward is pretty high if you screw it up, because the Emmy is always right there ready to get you. So, jump up through here, grapple there, jump, 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 and flash step. Now, here, because of the routing changes and stuff, this is our first official water bomb jump, so I will go through how to do this again, just in case you didn't see it in the last part or forget. So, to set up the water bomb jump, you may have noticed I actually set it up here. Go into a morphball, bounce, and make sure you land on your feet. When you land on your feet, this puts you in a glitch state, which will allow you to, well, let me show you. Place a water bomb. It'll allow you to bounce off a water bomb like that, or off a bomb. I always end up calling them water bombs. It's the only time bombs are used, pretty much. If you try to use a water bomb jump without putting yourself in the glitch state, as you can see, it does not work. So you have to use a bomb, land on your feet, that puts you in the glitch state, drop a bomb, jump up into the bomb, and this is what happens to me a lot lately because I need to come back. Because there's not as many water bomb jumps now as there used to be, I actually have to come back and practice this at some point. So this section up through here, you know what, I'm going to get Samus out of this gross murky water. This section up through here, there's several ways to go through it. I just suggest finding whatever way works best for you. The routing I take is I jump off this wall, jump off this wall, jump and flash step across there, but that jerk is in my way because, of course, I stopped and explained things to you guys, which throws off the whole flow of things, right? That's kind of the downfall with this guide. So we go here, jump, flash step across, jump up, flash step across. That's my method. There's other ways, some may be faster, some may be slower. Experiment and see what works best with you is about the best I can explain here. So next we'll do a little flash step here, bust that open with a diffusion shot. The reason we do that is coming up after defeating the thing in the room below there, as you can see on the mini-map, the Emmy will be up this way, and we want them to go through that door up there. So to go up through that, or go through this door up here, we have to unlock it. That's why we hit it with a charge shot. And going through here, this is the way we go down from here. There's a chance the Emmy will spawn to the right of where we land. And I hear the Emmy, so there's a chance. Now, where I'm standing right now, it can sometimes spawn here. So if it spawns here, flash step into the room as fast as you can. It makes it a little tricky because ideally you want to build up a speed tech here and then do this up into that. But I also want to show you what to do. That's why I didn't actively hit it with the shine spark. So if you get in a situation where the Emmy is to the right and you have to flash step in here, you either have to slowly take it out with missiles, charge shots like this, or this is really tight timing. I'm waiting for this to go. You can do the turnaround right here. I'm going to get hit by that. You can do the turnaround right here and store your shine spark just as you get to the wall and hit that. And then you just melee or mash. Tell you, there's too many M's. You mash that until you get through. Of course, always skip these scenes. Here, we don't want to flash step forward like we did with the yellow Emmy, because we're actually going to need a little extra speed from this spot because we're going to be speed boosting our way out. I typically like to do it from this line right about here. It gives me more than enough room. And then I store it here, jump up, diagonal flash step, or shine spark, and then the Emmy should be coming through here. And this enemy is kind of a pain in the rear to deal with, because there's, you need to be really precise with your aiming, and it has to be pretty tight. It's hard to keep on the enemy as it's moving. But if you can, it'll bust its face open right around here. In a spot that's kind of hard to see because it's behind your energy thing, but that's the kind of stuff you got to deal with this run. This enemy here, I call the troll enemy. And the reason I call it the troll enemy, it has so many spots that control you and freeze you and kill you. One of the first spots you saw where I had to rush through because I used the speed boost to go in through the initial room. It can be right there. I get frozen there a lot. It can be up above to the just forward enough that you can't actually squeak by it and go through the door in that same room when you first enter this whole area. And of course, the third place is where we just talked about. Please stop. I'm trying to talk. It can spawn right here and freeze you as you're falling down through here. So yeah, if you're falling down through here and you see the enemy there, that is your way to freedom. You have to flash step in there before you hit the beam, which is roughly at this height. It's tight, but it can be done without being froze. So we'll come up through here. I'm going to show you something here that I don't really see anyone else do as well. I don't know if it saves time. Most people just run out off. Well, I'll show you the way most people do it first. Most people just run out through here, bust this open, and fall down through here. Am I going to be able to get... I'm hoping I can get back up through here. I never thought this through. Okay, I'm actually going to have to load a checkpoint. So I'll show you where you land. You look to land here and head to the right. But the way I do it... Like I said, I can't imagine this saves time because I don't see... I literally see no one else do it. Either that or they've just never thought of it. So we'll go through here. But I can't... I have to imagine if I thought of it, other people have. I like to store a shine spark right here at this ledge, shoot this, and as I step off this ledge, shine spark down, which gets me down here to where I can get going a little bit faster. Store another one, flash step across there, and if I can do this in time, get up through here. I don't see anyone do that. So for me, when I do that compared to the other method, I save about 5 seconds. So that whole method right there, I suggest going back, learning it. Maybe do some comparisons if you're not sure which one's faster for you. Set up a live split just for that area. And start it as you start moving. And end it once you hit this point right here. See which one works best for you. But for me, everything you just saw there is what works best for me. I actively save like 5 seconds compared to doing it the other way, so... For me, that is the method I always use. In any case, we will pull this out, shoot a missile off, and I typically shine or speed boost through here, but other people will typically use their flash step through here. Either or, I don't think one really saves much time over the other. The flash step might be a hair faster. I haven't really compared the two to see. I've used the speed boost because for me it's a little easier. It's a little less tedious. At this point, you're quite late into the run. You're about an hour in, if not a little more, depending on how fast you are, how good you've gotten and whatnot. You'll be about an hour in at this point, and it gets a little tiring once you hit here. And now we come to what is probably one of the most frustrating pseudo shots. I'll show you two different ways to get in there. First one is just run through like this, jump once you hit this wall so you maintain the speed, and melee and aim down like that. We'll get to the meat and potatoes of how this is done in a moment. I want to show you the other way to get in here quickly. So we'd be starting right here, shine spark, melee, jump. And then, I didn't mean shine spark, I actually meant to aim down. I just hit down before anything else. Okay, so now, this guy here, he's a bit of a pain in the rear. We're actually looking to shoot the guy directly below us, Mr. Three Claw. And what is expected to happen here is, we shoot down at him, our diffusion beam ricochets off him, and hits the blob over there. So to set this up, you don't have to run in through here the way I did. You can run in through normal like this, but running in with the speed boost just, you know, saves time. That's kind of the point of a speed run. So once you get here, you melee and aim down, holding in your charge at the same time. You want the angle I'm at right now is pretty much exactly where you need to be pointing. And from here, I hate doing this because I miss this more often than not. So there's a method I have to this madness. So this is big claw when he does it deep, little claw, and then shoot. So you shoot after the one I call little claw is done quivering. And to shoot, I'll actually do it over here so I can show you. To shoot, you don't just shoot like this by releasing the charge button because the shot goes nowhere. You shoot by going into the morph ball with ZL, and that'll shoot down through the wall. But only if you do it right here and aim right about here. As you can see, it goes down through. I just did it there as an example to show you what it looks like if you're aiming in the right spot. So big claw, little claw, vibration shots, you shoot. So if you tie all this together, I'll try to tie it all together. I almost never get this on the first try. But if you come in through here, you can actually, if you come in through with your speed boost, it doesn't matter which speed tech you do, whether you're running in without the if you're running in like this, or if you use the other one I showed you, it doesn't matter. He'll be at the same state here. So there's where the quiver stopped. I shot a little early. That's what usually happens. But if you time that just right, you can actually blow that open there and move on. So I will try to show you what it looks like. It's tricky, but it can be done. So pretend that we just started over. Just got here, Shine Spark. I'll do this to save a little time, and I missed it. You have to jump off this ledge in order to get this right. That's why it's hard, because the ledge is usually off screen when you jump. So, you know, there's that. So you'll see that this won't matter. We can run in like this. It just gives us less time to repair or to prepare. That's what it looks like if you get it first shot. It's just, you'll get there as the little claw is starting to quiver. And as soon as that little claw stops quivering, you shoot. It's one that's really tricky to learn. There's people that when they do this, they'll use the enemy above his footsteps. Tunk, tunk, tunk. They'll time it out to that. There's a couple different spots you can shoot. I typically always do it where I showed you there, so I've never actually taken the method to learn otherwise. Big claw, which he digs it down deep. Little claw, where he just moves a little bit. And then shoot, when he stops quivering it. I'm actually going to show you one more time, because this is a tricky, tricky shot. Okay, so once again, I'm going to use this method, and I did it wrong. That happens. Okay, so I'm going to use this method. We store that melee jump, which we kept our speed this time. I did that too early, that's fine. So I want to show you the big claw, little claw thing again. The big claw, we're looking at the back claw, by the way, in case you didn't know. I should have specified that earlier, and I apologize for that. So big claw, little claw, shoot. It's just like maybe 5 to 10 frames after the claw stopped quivering. It's almost immediately. Once you see that claw stop quivering, try to react to that and you'll get it. Don't try to anticipate it. If you try to anticipate it, you will shoot early, which is what causes you to miss that. So try to wait till you see the stop and then go into the morph ball. And you'll almost always sometimes get it. I have to say it like that. There's no guarantee. So in any case, you saw I shot those little guys coming down through here. We jump, grab. Ideally, you want to grab this ledge right along here if you can. It's a blind jump, so you just got to do it by feel, get used to it. To get up over this quicker, you can actually just jump up and around like that. And same with here. You'll grab this ledge, jump up and around, go into a morph ball. You want to go into the morph ball because, once again, morph balls are quicker to go through. So you grab that with a flash step if you want to. You don't have to use a flash step. I was actually in so far that the flash step didn't help me at all. So from here, we're actually going for the screw attack, which has a lot of tech to it. And I think with the new tech that we have that's allowed in the No Major Glitches run, what I'm about to show you once we get to the shine spark, or to the shine spark, geez, once we get to the space jump, will be obsolete. But what you have to do there is really tight timing. It requires a really hard trick to do. So for beginners or advanced users, I would suggest doing it the way you're going to see here. So we're going to head back out, go into roll. We jump across here, jump here, grab on this. You can jump up here higher if you want to. You don't have to. We'll jump across there after freezing him, jump more, drop a bomb so we can get through here. Try to drop down through here. There's a spot here you can shoot out. Ideally, as you're falling down through, you'll shoot that spot out and grab on the ledge so you can just climb in. Unfortunately, I miss it most of the time, so we'll shoot our way through here. Shoot those guys, get them out of the road. Shoot as we're sliding there. Grapple here, slide and go in through this fast. I got too big of a jump, but that's fine. If you notice, I didn't leave the morph ball there because you don't actually need to leave the morph ball there. Falling down through as a morph ball is fast enough that the slower movement for the little spots that you have to land doesn't really lose you much. It actually doesn't lose you any time at all that I know of. So next we're going down through here. We actually don't want to slide down this. We want to jump and flash step, because that flash stepping down through here is a lot faster. Now with this, you can either shoot it four times to blow it out, or use instant charge shots like that, which, as you can see, it's a tight little spot, so it is kind of hard to do. So if you're having trouble with it, just give it a few shots like that till it blows up. It will only cost you like half a second to maybe a second. Then you use two flash steps to get here. Now, I don't think I've mentioned it yet in this video, but you do see there's an Xbox controller here. It's been showing my inputs this whole time. So I'm actually using a Switch controller. The layout where the buttons are lighting up is exactly where they should be. So this is A, B, X, Y. I feel like I need to point that out every time. Okay, in any case, we're back here in Dairon. So this time when we're in Dairon, we don't talk to him anymore. We skip by him. We'll have flash steps, so we'll use this here, or shine spark. Use this here, take it to here, and go to the right. You can use an instant shine spark there, but I didn't for this, or just for demonstration purposes. Mainly, if I'm to be honest, I forgot to. But that'll get you through that little segment quicker. You can just run through there if you want to, but one way is a little faster than the other, I think. So we'll flash step over that, and then we need to run again. Start shooting down, slide into a morph ball. So I slid into a morph ball, but I came out by mistake. So the way this works ideally is, as you're going through here, I'll try it again. I usually don't get this, so you shoot that, you morph ball, come out of the morph, continue to shoot. I didn't get that door opened in time, but you continue to shoot. Store your shine spark here. Shine spark up, flash step left, roll, and land here. Push it down with your foot. This area here, I like to call Teleport Alley. I don't know if that's what like the official name for it is. In all honesty, I do not follow the speedrunning community as close as I should. I got lucky and found out that there was new tech that was allowed, so I went and checked that out. But I never go to the Discord and look through that stuff. All the stuff that I've noticed, I've learned from watching other people's speedruns, and then I've tried to figure them out myself. And yeah, anything I haven't been able to figure out, I look for guides or tutorials on. And I've made tutorials for most any of it too. In any case, we're here in Artaria, so we bust this out. We head down to the right, down to the left, flash step here, shoot this guy out, jump up this way. Some people build up a shine spark here, some people don't. I am one of those that I like to build one up here. Hit it there, two down, and then instant shine spark down just to get down through here. I noticed not everyone does that now, so here's the other caveat here. So I'm gonna get him out of the road just so I can show you. Depending on the routing you took early on, so if you filled the water up here so you could go down that way, you might as well just take this way to get down to the next area, so it'll take you down through to here. But if, like I did, we took this route, so we just go up through here, roll down through there, flash step across here, go into a morph ball, flash step across here. I'm trying to do this stuff quickly because I noticed a lot of these videos are getting quite long. So, here's the other thing I wanted to touch on before I actually got out here. You notice I shot that with an ice missile. I typically do that because I want my ice missiles for out here, because you need to blow that out with a missile. So I'll show you how it would typically go. We would bust that door open, then run immediately. You can store this or not, it doesn't matter, we're not actually going to be using it. We're going to flash step through here. I kind of messed up my flash step a little bit. Jump up through here as quickly as we can. And ideally, if you get through there as fast as you can, you'll only lose one bar of health. I was a little slow this time around because I made a mistake and jumped in there, so we lost a little bit of time. But in any case, right here, we bomb our way through. Make use out of instant charge jump. And now we gotta do the water bomb jump trick again. So I've already taught you how to do this, you should know now. But you know what, just in case, I'll go through it once again. Maybe you skipped it from earlier in this video, I'm not sure. So to set up a water bomb jump, you go into the morph ball and land on your feet. This puts you in a glitch state. From here, we'll jump, morph ball, jump up into the morph ball, or jump up and morph into the bomb, and it will bounce us up high enough that we can grab this ledge. From here, you're looking to jump across there and grind on that corner. Ideally, if you do this right, you'll only need to grind on that corner twice and you'll be able to get up through there. So let me see if I can show you that. So I do 1, 2, 3 jumps back forth like this. I'm missing my grind a little bit. We're almost there. So that wasn't ideal. So I'm going to try to show you again. So 1, 2. That's how you want it to go ideally. The best way to do that, you notice I came out. I didn't count jumping off this. So when I go here, this is 1, 2. I'm down a little low this time, but we can pull that back. If you're down low, it just takes a little more. But ideally, you want to get that in 2 jumps. So 1, 2. And you can get up through there. So one thing here, you can switch to morph ball and go up through like that, or you can have a charge shot held in, which I almost never do, but it's worth doing because these guys will always spawn through and sometimes you'll get hit. So if you have a charge shot and you climb up in, it'll automatically shoot them if they're on screen. You won't take a hit like I just did there. Once you get up here, sliding into a morph ball, if you do it right, which I didn't, if you do it right, you'll land in here as a morph ball. Though I wish I could go back and show you, but I don't think I can get out of here with a water bomb jump. Oh, actually I can. I've never had to try it before, so I didn't know. So that's what it's supposed to look like. And that has us in a morph ball. I always give a little hop in this area and make sure I stay into a morph ball, because we gotta set up another water bomb jump. So boom. This time I'm not gonna tell you how to do it, because I literally told you 2 minutes ago over there. Okay, so from here we jump, lay the bomb down, jump, and grab the ledge. I've been having real troubles with this lately, so I'm glad I got that. So shoot that as you're climbing up, and we now have the screw attack. There's a couple different ways to get out of here. I'll show you both methods. I'll show you the easy one first. I actually, in this instance, I typically use the easy method. So as you saw, when I came up here, I jumped up through there. I used my flash shift to go over this, because if you step on that half, it will tilt down. And if you're taking the harder method, the method I will show after this, you'll want to step there so you drop straight down. But in this instance, we want to be over here because we need to store a shine spark. This door is useless. We can't open it, so don't even bother trying. We need to get right up against this door pretty much. So we'll be doing that method where you gotta turn and activate your shine spark as you're turning. Doing this will give you just enough room. So as you are crossing this circle, hit down to store your shine spark. If you're lucky, you will store it and fall down. If you're unlucky, you will store it over that side, which leaves you less time to maneuver around. Either way, let's run over how this goes. We store this, go down, go into a morph ball so we can get over here quickly, activate the shine spark, and we're good. The harder method, I actually don't have to load a checkpoint for this one, thankfully. I don't want to go up here either. I didn't mean to hit that out. So we can't actively jump out of here or anything. I've seen people do the water bomb jump here without setting up the glitch for it. I can't do that, and I don't know why. So I set up a water bomb jump glitch here. You have to, as you saw there, this is really hard to do. This is a very tight window. After you set this up, your bomb needs to be at the height of your jump, at the peak of your jump, so right there. And then you gotta quickly get into a spin. And you notice I do this off of this wall. The reason I do this off this wall is so when I'm jumping, I can hold left and it will kick me off this wall over that way. As you can see, you don't quite go high enough to do it like that here, but if we set up the water bomb jump, it gives you just a few frames more to jump off that wall to get up here. This is the quicker method. I wasn't going to need to do this, but I'll load the last checkpoint and show you just how much quicker it is. All right, so this method here, also if you're a beginner, you can grab those missiles if you want to have extra. But at this point, you almost have what you need. You only need 45 missiles for Raven Beat, if you can fight them without missing a single shot. I typically go in with 53 to 55, just to be on the safe side. But in any case, back to the trick at hand. Normally you would jump up here and go right straight down through here. Please stop. Oh my god. Please stop saying, oh my, you know what? I'm just going to go off there normal. How about that? Jeez. So you set up the water bomb. And then you just jump up out of there like that. That compared to going up there, setting up a shine spark, come down, going down through here, shine sparking up, and then continue on. This will save you probably about 5 to 7 seconds, but it's a lot harder to do. I'm making it look easy, and I don't know how I'm making it look easy. I usually struggle very hard with this. So once again, we'll go down through here. I always go into a morph ball falling here just because you fall faster. We now have to go across here to that ledge once again, grinding that very same corner over there. If you want it to feel familiar, so you did it like you did the first time, you come down here, 1, 2. I got under it. If you get caught under it, thankfully you can come over here and grab yourself if you're lucky. If not, you gotta do a water bomb jump from here. So I do want to touch on that too. With the new tech that was introduced and is allowed for the No Major Glitches run, all this jumping across here, at least the first time, will be skipped, because you can actually store a shine spark and spark from here up to there, cutting out having to do the first water bomb jump, or the water bomb jump at all. Anyway, so like I said, 1, 2, and then you grind off that a couple times. For whatever reason, I have a harder time doing this when we have the shine spark. And I think it's because the aura around you is a little bigger, so it's a little harder to judge things. But I came back over this way so I could show you. You don't have to grab on that ledge. It's just, if you're starting out, it's easier to go from that ledge. So if you do it from here, it's 1, 2. And it works out pretty much the same way. You can get up here with the same two jumps. I was just a little low on it. So, come on, guys. Cooperate just once. I always drop bombs on them because these guys are awful trolls. So now we're going to come all the way up through to here. We're going to shoot this open, flash step across here. And to blow this open, there's actually two methods. I'll show you the method I first learned, which is you go into a morph ball, go back to the morph ball center, the green spot is almost off screen. Melee back that way, aim at this gray block about middle way of it, and then go into the morph ball and it'll shoot it out. The newer method, and I'm actually going to have to load last checkpoint to show you. I don't typically do this method. It is faster if you can do it consistently. I'm not at the point that I can do it consistently yet, so it's not faster for me. So for me, I typically stick with the other method. I haven't missed this once tonight. What the hell? There we go. Do that just to... I'm actually going to slow down and hit them. I've actually... During runs, I've slowed down and hit them before when they follow behind me. I hate them that much because they've screwed me over so bad. Okay, so the other method... I'm not 100% sure where you stand just yet. Charge up your charge. I think you stand right along here, so your foot is near this line right here. So, you duck down, aim back toward that gray block, and as you can see, I struggle with this one a little more because I don't know exactly where to stand. It might be a hair closer, but I know if you get too close, it doesn't work either. So, aim back at that block. I might be too far ahead. This one, like I said, this one here, it's quicker if you can do it. But it's also a lot harder. This is another pseudo wave. Like, this is a new way to do a pseudo wave that I'm not used to. There it is. As you can see, a lot tougher. It's pretty tight where you have to stand. And I haven't quite figured out exactly where you stand yet. I think it's somewhere along this line here, but I don't know exactly where. So next up, well, we gotta do some tight jumps. We're looking to jump up through that section, which is not easy. I have a method that has helped me quote unquote master this, although I've been slipping on it lately. So the method here is where we're standing right now on this circle, jump two times, and you want two full jumps so you don't go like... You don't do quick jumps like that. You do one, two, three, four, five. Okay, I caught on the ledge up there. But you can do this in like four or five jumps. So it goes one, two, three, four, five, six. If you can get it clean like that, you will save a lot of time. You don't want to fall down in there. The water's all filled up there, as you can see. So if you fall down there, you have to take a very roundabout way, which I... Oh no, I fell. I will show you the roundabout way because we actively can't do any of this, right? So if you fall down in here, and the reason this all has its water is because we did the skip up above where this was. So if you fall down in here, you might as well just reload the checkpoint because you got to blow this open, drain all this water out, and then take the route that you would to go up through. So you would go up through here to get caught back up. And this is not ideal. You don't want to have to take this route because it costs you a lot of time. So this right here, well worth learning. So one, two, three, four, five, six. As you can see, I'm taking the jumps right to the edge. And this may seem like a spot that you don't need to practice because they're like, oh, that doesn't look that hard. These jumps are quite precise. That's why I tell you, I emphasize, you have to do the big jumps. You can't just do the quick little hops like that. To do it the way I'm doing it, to get up through there as clean as I do without fetching on anything, these jumps are one, and haha, I was back here a little too far. You have to be pretty much center of this. So one, two, three, four, five. So there, I didn't do this jump. I didn't go over to that wall quite far enough. So one, two, three, four, five, six. Notice how when I get on four, I go four. I drag that one out as long as I possibly can before I do jump five. From there, we go up through here. Flash step our way through this spot. Didn't mean to go into the morph ball, but that's fine. Bomb or blow that out. Go up through here. And we're on to Catarus or Catarus. Yeah, we've actually been here before. I mentioned how we would go to this section. And this section here in particular will be taking a different route than we did the first time. Okay, so now we're here in Catarus. You notice this is a spot we've been before. As I mentioned early in this run, there's two ways to go. We'd be coming back to this spot. The first time you took that route, the fact that that's broken out is your reminder to do not go that way. So instead, we'll slide over this way. My slide didn't slide. We will slide over this way, drop a bomb, come up through here. We luckily have our screw attack, so we can take out most everything. You don't need to fight any of this. I just wanted to stop and explain. If you didn't take the Adam's save skip route, this is something you would already have blown out. But since we took the Adam's save skip, we will take now to blow it out, which takes 4 shots or just a couple charge shots. So I typically go for the couple charge shots like that. Because of the diffusion beam, it spreads through this wall. So as long as you're hitting here, you'll pretty much guaranteed hit it. So when we go into this next room, it's a hot room. We don't get burned by those anymore, thankfully. So we will go through, jump our way up through here. Hopefully not grab on. We don't want to grab on this right here because it actually slows us down. As you saw, it messed up my jumps. We're going through this teleportal right here. Like I said, we're in the teleport zone. There's a lot of it in this. This whole video shows the majority of the teleporting all around. And there is a lot of it. But we're almost done at the very least. Alright, now we're in Gavaron once again. We want to jump and use a charge shot, which for whatever reason didn't cooperate. That's what it was looking to be. Slide here, shoot that open, slide to the left. More fall to fall faster, shoot this out, shoot that out, slide through, shoot this out, shoot this out. Morph and bomb, slide, morph and bomb. Slide, slide, and, well, you don't need to morph and bomb that. I tried to shoot it, but I slid first by mistake. So, in this section, there's actually 2 different ways to go once again. I'm actually going to show you the harder way first, because the harder way is, funny enough, the slower way. So we blow that thing out as I did there. Start up a shine spark. Fun fact, this is the spot where I learned to do the instant shine spark, and this is where my tutorial takes place for it. So we go down through here. Jump up here and use an... Oh, it ran out. Shoot. Well, we're supposed to use an instant shine spark. I haven't done this one in a while. And I think when I paused it, I slowed myself down enough that I didn't make it. So I'll try to show you that again. So store that. Fall down through. Instant shine spark across. And then you fall through those blocks to the right. I'm not going to go over there yet because... I want to show you the other method. It's the way I use now because I think it's faster. At least if you can do it optimally. Provided I can get up through here. Okay. So the other way is you would shoot this out, land here, blow this thing out. Flash step through here, go through here, blow that out, jump here. Go into a morph ball, come out of the morph ball, jump. Jump and go into the morph ball. And then land on this and go. I think that method is just a little bit faster. You can test both, see which one you prefer to do. That's why I showed both, even though I believe the one I did second is definitely easier. And I think it's a little bit faster. So this next section is brutal. I still screw this spot up from time to time. And I'm hoping that... this time will not be one of those times, but I fully expect it to be one of those times. Speaking of time, oh my god, it's almost midnight. So I started recording this today around 7 p.m. And it's 11:42 p.m. And I'm still not done. So we want to slide, coming out of this, we want to slide into that. A lot of people will come back out and slide in like this each time. But I don't typically do that. I'm actually going to come out here and let all these spawn back in and show you how I do it. Okay, so the way that I do this, I come out of this, I slide into the first one, go in there, drop a bomb as soon as the first one blows up. So when you're way back there, the bomb will still work, as you can see. So I'll do this in real time just to show you what it looks like. So we'll say we already blew the first one out. So the second one would go there, third would go there, fourth would go there. I find that to be quicker than going out and sliding back in each time. Because you're actively already there dropping your next bomb as soon as the first one blows up. And that's less movement time to deal with. So we shoot these out, coming down through here. And now we gotta do a shine spark to get down through here. A couple of different ways to do this. I'll show you the method I use. I actually gotta wait for that door to close because I need to start moving immediately. So we're gonna shoot that door open, run, jump off this wall, store a shine spark there, slide through here, charge this up, go diagonal, slide, hold down, flash step through here, more fall, and go right. And that'll get us here. We want to pick up these missiles. It's an extra 10. I'm going to have more missiles than I normally do this run. I'm going to have like 60 some. I picked up a lot of missiles I wouldn't normally. So the other way, I'm going to come back through this stuff and show you a different method you can do. The different method is a lot harder, but it will save you a little time. I've actually never done this before, so I don't expect to be able to get it, in all honesty. So we start off. Store this, come through here, didn't mean to do that, I went down too far is the problem. So what I was meant to do, I was just a little slow on the shine, or on the spark. I wanted the shine spark into that, curve right there. Doing that will allow you to start running where you can store it again once you hit that flat surface. So I've done it in recovery before, but I've never actually tried to do it straight out. So that was my first time trying to do it straight up, and I didn't expect it to work because I haven't practiced it. So use your flash step to get through here. I only charge that there because I feel like I need to. So you would do, well, I wasn't spinning. I tried to recover it there. I will get this. I'll take a little while and practice this so I can show it to you. Okay, so you go like this. There we go. There we go. So you get to see both. The way it looks, if you're falling down through, you need to be in a spin. Or you can't be in a spin. You got to use your instant shine spark, which I failed on, but we recovered it. I didn't know you could actually store it in the slant either. I've never seen that happen before. But if you fail that, you can actually jump back and shine spark back into it to recover and save yourself. Then you just come down through here, instant shine spark your way through, and then we'll continue on this way. That way's a little bit faster. There's a faster way still, like up in this section right here. As you're falling, you can set up an instant shine spark and shine spark into this slant. I haven't practiced that yet, and I know something like that is going to be something that I'd have to sit here for a couple hours to do, so I don't have the time to sit there and properly do that. This is a more beginner and intermediate guide anyway, and I consider that to be a more advanced thing. Anything I don't do is basically something I see as more advanced, because it's the things that you do that save like extra frames or like an extra half second, and I don't feel like my run's where it needs to be for that yet. So until I need those, I don't use them. In any case, what you ideally want to do coming down through here is come out of the morph ball and start shooting down. I was a little slow on that, or in fact, I didn't do it at all. We come out there. I always shoot them because if I don't, they kind of come back and hit me. But to get up and around here, this is simple enough to do. As you're coming out of here, you jump and just turn around and grab that ledge. You'll do it here again. And this one here, I like to grab on the ledge like this and climb up. So as we're climbing up through that hole, it shoots a first charge shot there. So the second one, I'll go like that. Then I'll use a couple instant charge shots here and grab this. Climb up here, fall down in. You saw me do the little hop so I would stay in the morph ball, because you fall through the water faster in the morph ball. Ideally, you want to try to start jumping as you come across here. So you land on this spot. I landed down there this time. Not a big deal. It'll just cost you like a second or so. So double missile. You don't have to do double missile. Just double missile makes it easier to do that. You can just go into your morph ball and start bouncing here afterward. And then shine spark into this. Skip this cutscene as soon as you see the white. And we now have the gravity. And we are done this video. Thank goodness. I think there's only going to be one more video to this series. I got to look over things and see what's left. But I think I can cover the rest of it because there's no... there's definitely no more diverging paths from here on. It's just going to be different strategies for taking out bosses and stuff. So yeah, that's our gravity suit, which, yay, we can now move normal in water. So this is where I'm going to end things as a Samus gravity suit morph ball. If this video has been helpful to you, let me know by leaving a big old thumbs up. I will have this whole guide in a playlist so you can just set it up and it'll go one after another. Set up your auto play to on and you should be good for that. Any other tutorials or guides I have for individual tricks that have more in-depth detail than what I've been given here, although I've explained them here pretty much the same way. But I will include those in the comments down below. It'll be the top pinned comment. And yeah, I don't think I have too much left to say. I've got one more part of this to record, so I kind of want to get to that before my throat completely dies on me. Check out these videos off to the side if you're still here. Truly appreciate that. And see you guys in the next one. Later.